Welcome to video number 2 on Flight Sim Navigation. And in this video we are going to find out how we can fly to or from an NDB. So here I am. I'm on a visual flight to Eindhoven and well, it's getting a bit dark and I'm not 100% sure where I am at the moment. So yeah, where is that airport? Well, of course, when planning the flight I use the Eindhoven approach chart, and there is an NDB in the same direction as runway 21 and the frequency of it is 397, which means that I can tune 397 here in the automatic direction finder radio, and then the pointing device should point me directly to that NDB. So let me dial in this frequency 397 over here in the radio of the automatic direction finder. I'm rotating the mouse wheel to change these digits, and look what happens now. The needle is starting to move and it now points 45 degrees left. Note that our current heading is pure west 270. So let's have a look what this means. Here we are, flying a heading of 270 pure west, and then that NDB is over here, 397, I just tuned into that, and my needle showed me this, which means I have to go 45 degrees left. When I do that, well, this should be the result. I should be flying straight towards that NDB. We could do this the quick and dirty way, which means glancing at the needle and then imagining that same needle over there on my heading indicator. Or we could do it the neat way, which is rotate my dial on the ADF such that it 100% resembles my heading indicator, and then as a second step I can place my heading bug at the right course, the course that this needle is pointing to, which I can now read out over here. By the way, after having dialed in a frequency in the radio, it's always good practice to check the Morse code, which we can do by pressing one of these buttons, and this is the ADF button over here. The Morse codes are presented on the map. Let me now change this dial on the ADF, the automatic direction finder, to have exactly the same heading over here as on my heading indicator. Now I can read out the needle. It says 220. Okay, Morse code correct. So I can now rotate the heading bug to 220 and let the autopilot do the rest. Let's see where we end up. The needle is moving, and once the needle is perfectly vertical, that means that we are flying straight to the NDB, which is more or less right now. Well, maybe I should go a little bit more to the left. You always fly to the needle, so if it's left, you fly to the left, and when the needle is exactly centered, then we are on the course to the NDB. And look what happened. We have the airport in sight over here. Let me zoom in a little. Yeah, there are the landing lights. So we did a very good job. There is a very nice website built by Louis Montero that gives us a simulator of the NDB, and also, by the way, of VORs and others. This is the simulator. We were flying on a heading straight west, indicated here, and the NDB needle was pointing to the left. And when I rotated this dial to exactly resemble the heading indicator, we can read out the heading that we need to fly, which in this case is 220. And then in the simulator, I can fly that heading 220. And then I can see that the needle is pointing straight up, which means the NDB is right in front of my nose. And by the way, this simulator can also really fly. I'm not going to do that right now, but you can start it and it flies the plane just like real. What happens if we fly over an NDB? Well, then we first see the needle go crazy a bit, and then once we passed, then the needle stabilizes and now points behind us. The NDB is on my tail. Well, which is perfectly the correct situation, of course. Well, this was it for flying to or from an NDB. Let's in the next video make this all a little bit more fun and try to intercept a certain bearing to the NDB. Suppose that I'm flying here and I know that the airport is on a 210 bearing to the NDB. That means I have to intercept this 210 bearing, but I am not there yet, I am over here. How can we accomplish that? That's the subject of the next video. Maybe see you back there.